It's been estimated that the world needs to double its food supply, double the production of food in the next 40 years. And since plant pathogens are a major cause of reduction in yield, it's very important to try to reduce disease. We study a species called Phytophthora infestans, which is a member of a larger group of plant pathogens that are sometimes called water molds. Phytophthora infestans is a very important and historic organism. It was first identified in the mid-1800s as a cause of the Irish potato famine. It still exists throughout the world and is a threat to both to potato production and to tomato production. So the problem with disease is twofold. One is that it reduces yield. The other is that it's expensive to battle disease. In an affluent society or a country like the United States or Europe, most growers can afford to spray their crops with large amounts of chemicals. We can contrast that with the developing world. Many growers in the developing world cannot afford to use these chemicals. Consequently, they often have massive reductions in the yield in a season. Our strategy is both to come up with better ways to battle Phytophthora infestans and related organisms, as well as to try to come up with more economical, as well as an environmentally benign methods for battling these pathogens. We're using multiple strategies to try to find ways to defeat Phytophthora infestans and its relatives. One thing we do in the laboratory is that we study genes and proteins that we think play important roles in the growth of Phytophthora. This includes its ability to form its reproductive structures and its ability to infect plants and acquire nutrients from plants. So once we identify proteins that are important for Phytophthora's growth or pathogenicity, we're then able to take several strategies to exploit that information to defeat the pathogen, at least in theory. One approach would be to identify chemicals that could be used to inhibit the activity of those proteins. Another approach would be to try to manipulate the plant in order to retard the development of a certain metabolic pathway, for example, that Phytophthora needs to grow. The way we do research is that we do it with junior scientists and graduate students. So a large part of what I do is providing mentorship to graduate students in my laboratory. We also have undergraduates in the laboratory that are learning at the early stage of their careers what science is like. One thing that's really good about UC Riverside is that it has these agriculturally based departments, such as the Department of Plant Pathology and Microbiology, to which I belong. And these foster multidisciplinary research that allows us to address plant diseases from multiple directions. We're trying to put information in the hands of growers, so we have people doing basic research, fundamental types of science, like in my laboratory. We're trying to put information in the hands of extension personnel, and then ultimately to the growers to help them battle the disease.